Buddha said, if you put on this mortal body and mortal dread, you will make sure that you are, you will be assured that you are going to receive happiness in this life and hereafter. So you will progress in your spiritual practice. Find the power of the Siddha. And this moral dress is always in question. And ordinary conventional clothing, the children's clothing, cannot be worn by grown up people. And also the old man, old girl's clothing, cannot be worn by young people. So it is always to choose the appropriate dress. But in time, so the moral clothing and moral dress. The child is a young person, an old person, middle aged person, can take this moral dress. It is suitable for all ages. All occasions. So modern dress is very much fashionable. It never goes out of fashion. So let's take the present.
Sayadaw Ashin Thitzana.
moment of being, moment of self. So we go with self. But in the case of the, like we say, with the main spiritual second part, we don't walk up. We don't walk up. We don't know what to do. We don't even cure. One example is the Buddha example. When he attained enlightenment, I already mentioned, for 7 days, he can remain in one cross-eyed city, enjoying the bliss. This man is fully entitled into a liberated state. In other words, he is enjoying the supreme peace and bliss. Nibbana. Nibbana in this day is a limit. A limit which is very described, very difficult to describe. The nature of it is very delicate. Why Buddha was in to it? No harm. No injury, no outside danger can affect. This is how physical suffering is protected by the wonderful power of the Dhamma. Another example is about committed meditator who have been going through a lot of physical pain. One practical example is about my old teacher who passed away in the year 2001, I think. He's in Berlin. He's suffering from colon cancer. In the last stage, he's crucifying me. Very famous doctor came to treat. They're trying to give him morphine injection so that he will feel no pain. He refused. Instead, he just keep meditating. Even though he is in great execution, he never shook any kind of pain, no pressure distortion, no pressure grimacing, etc. While he is going through such pain, he reached the last moment. He passed away. His faith is brilliant. When his body is committed, then the rent is come on him. This is very interesting. So please understand that overcoming suffering, being free from suffering, is two stages. One is from mental suffering, one is from physical suffering. Physical suffering is totally impossible to liberate today. Because on the body, there will be some sort of pain and suffering, which is subject to the element, which is some sort of disease and pain. But in the case of the daily person, it is bearable. It's bearable. People can get through the process of pain without screaming, without complaining, without asking for help, children, family members, doctors. So, as I explained to you in the previous day, meditation is a very wonderful protective plate, protective armor. aware, even when you go back to your home, please try to work on this vipassana, protective karma, very important. This way you will benefit lots in daylight. Now let me conclude. By coming to this mental retreat and practicing meditation, by observing my present form, this energy, and by doing challenge in any way you can, by doing some volunteer work, by listening to Dhamma, by practicing Dhamma, you have acquired a lot of wholesome Maitreya energy. By all this Maitreya energy, you aspire to attain Nirvana, to progress in the spiritual path, to develop the insight knowledge, to develop the affirmation knowledge, and in the right amount, right and holy amount, may infinite power of the true virgin lead you on the right track until you develop necessary inside knowledge and body fusion knowledge in the wonderful bliss of the Supreme Being.